I think in the agenda itself, I think there has to be provisions for diversity. That I think all of these agendas need to start from principles, such as principles of fairness. Fairness not being the same as sameness, but fairness for all. And as soon as we start to say that and have that kind of conversation, then we get to inclusivity of diverse communities and regions and locales. That's absolutely critical. And particularly when you're talking about First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people who are constitutionally recognized in Canada as distinct and having special status. We have to go there, and they have to be an integral part. We only have to look at the inequities and disparities in this country to see our First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people. Now that said, there's also some great resilience and solutions that are equally possible. And so I see those pieces as opportunities for addressing the inequities and disparities that we do experience. I think one of the most important pieces for First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people in Canada around a health equity agenda is the availability of disaggregated data. If we don't have that data, we can't create the evidence pathways to help us to find those solutions and to advocate for change. So that notion of disaggregated data is absolutely critical. So collaborations are absolutely vital. And I like to think about those as alliances, as allies that we are, because to me that brings that whole equity piece into our relationship with each other as we strive toward a common goal. I mean, imagine if we had a table and we sat down and I laid out all my gifts and you laid out all your gifts. What we could build with that toward a common vision and a common goal. And I think that is the exciting part about opportunity, exciting part about entering into relationships that are real and that we are allies in our vision for health and well-being for all Canadian people. I think those things are really fundamental if we're going to think about equity.